Well, in thinking about War and Peace with Carolina Change, which was the production I directed this year, it's set in a historical moment in 1963, and America was in the Vietnam War, and the main character, Caroline, her son is in Vietnam, and she's worried about what could happen to him. So that, I think that was the main, I mean, the play is not about war per se, maybe a little domestic war over a $20 bill, but it's really more about how the great sweep of history affects little people, ordinary people who are going through their own problems, but are also caught up in something much bigger than they are.
Wolfchild is about colonization. It's about how do we as human beings coming to a new human being or a new person indoctrinate and enculture other people. And that has War and Peace entangled with it.
The War and Peace and the costume shop only really got along in like a couple instances. The opera and Antigone. And really Antigone was the one where we had to search for military clothes and find things that we don't normally have to find.
We made helmets. And then the cross between the British uniforms, but not letting them be well known that they were British, and then bringing in some American things and letting that not be well known either.
My biggest memory from the season, well, there's not a single memory that I have many, but one thing that I was very excited about was when I saw Carolina Change. And the reason for that wasn't necessarily just about that production, but it was, I felt like this program was an awesome program and that I came to the right place. No one likes to make a lateral move in their profession. Nobody likes to make a move down. I felt like I made a move up in my career coming here, which means then I have to up my game, and I'm working really hard at doing that. So it's a great memory. I thought it was a brilliant production. And the productions that I've seen in the wake of that, too, have also been similarly astounding in their own way. So it's exciting.
The biggest memory for me was when we did our methods internship at Ragsdale High School, and I watched four future educators really come into their own and understanding that bringing art and craft and education collaboration to people is not as easy as it sometimes lives in UNCG, and what they were willing to do and how they were willing to think outside the box and how they were willing to risk in educating people that didn't necessarily trust them. And so that's what I remember the most. And even as they're working in individual schools now, I see the impact that those moments had on their work.
My biggest memory was the fact that we lost a bunch of the Can-Can costumes 2 days before dress rehearsal.
Not we. But someone.
They got dropped on the way to the car to sew them. We had no clue where they were. And I put a call out to parking and facilities and grounds, and the groundskeepers found them in a trash can. They were brought back to us. I immediately ran them to the dry cleaner because it looked like someone had possibly vomited on them. So they were dry cleaned and returned back to
us. They were totally clean, girls.
I have the same goal pretty much at the beginning of every semester, and that's survival. We do a lot of shows and we're real busy. So my goals are basically the same thing, is I want to get every show up and done and ready to and be ready by the time we get to dress rehearsals. We have pretty much hit that goal every semester. So it's been a pretty successful semester for us.
My goals always focus around becoming a better theater artist, and you know, you become a better theater artist through collaboration, through really accepting other people for who and what they are. And in this program in the past year, coming in with that goal to become a more well-rounded theater artist has really happened. every day that I'm able to learn something new from somebody, whether it's an undergraduate, whether it's a fellow grad student, whether it's a faculty, just coming in every day with that mindset of I want to grow today and how can I do that?
Well, I haven't reached my goal because I'm never going to reach my goal. I asked my mom, who's 84, a few years ago, I said, is there ever a moment when you arrive in your life where you go, I made it, I've arrived, and she said, I still haven't arrived at that moment. So you never arrive at the moment, right? Because our goals are always a moving target. The thing to remember is to enjoy living life in the moment as we move toward those goals. So yeah, I mean, I forgot the rest of the question. What was the other question? What was the other part of that?
Met that when Bash was definitely as successful, if not more successful, than last year. Rush Week, if not more successful. Winter Briefs, the list goes on. I think that we just, again, continue to grow from where we started last year. And I wind up feeling down. Pushed all of our playwrights and our directors involved in Winter Briefs, as well as the creative team, to have that sense of theme that we wanted to show throughout the season. I think that was definitely a challenge that we met and conquered full force.
I don't know what to say. All right, fine. Whatever comes out, comes out.
But then when they merge together, it can... Really, I don't know what I'm saying. This isn't making any sense.
My biggest memory from the season will be what just happened last night with the Grand Curtain catching fire during final dress rehearsal for the opera. We gon' be all right. We gon' be all right.
We gon' be all right. We gon' be all right. That's gonna be something I'll be talking about for quite a while.
So.
Thank you, ladies, so much.
Yes.
That is?
Thank you.
All right,
thank
you're gonna make me look thin, right?
Yes. Well, thank
That's
you.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Cool.
Thank you. Cool.
Thank you. That is cool. All of our questions.
Yay.
Thank you. Cool. Yes. Awesome.